Well, the perfect football pass, it's mostly Newton's laws. Newton was a pretty smart guy. There's at least three reasons why throwing the ball in a spiral is important. It makes the flight of the ball more stable because it's always got the sort of the same cross-section in the air. It's got the narrow cross-section into the air, reduces the drag so the ball can go further for a given throwing velocity. And finally, when it comes into the receiver, it's a predictable orientation catch. Football came from rugby, and then as passing took over in football, the ball got longer and narrower. It made it easier to carry, and it made it easier to throw. Here's a gyroscope over here. That's going to be our football after it's left the quarterback's hand. If we push on it, it wants to stay where it is. That's the stability of the gyroscope. If it's not rotating exactly about that axis, but slightly off, then it will wobble. And that's the wobble you often see as the football comes down into the receiver's hand. You know, freshman physics, we say, well, let's ignore air resistance. But quarterbacks can't do that. For example, if it's a windy day, you have to try to do more low, flat passes than get them up high in the wind. When it's cold, the air is a little denser than it is on a warm day, and that's going to make a little bit more air drag, and the ball isn't going to go as far. So lots of things, you know, to keep in mind, but really it's the quarterback and his receivers. It's just automatic. I'm Professor Ed Groth. I'm an Emeritus Professor of Physics at Princeton University.